This is Storm Track 12.
It's a night of wild weather here across the Twin Tiers as the storm system off to our northwest continues to intensify and also drift off to the northeast. And taking a look down towards Johnson City right now, what this SkyCam image will not show you is that about 10 minutes ago, it was completely a whiteout outside as a band of snow moved its way through. And that is something we will be dealing with the rest of the night as this storm system continues to trek through the region. Look at all of that snowfall here on the southern side of the storm. Now that we are on the back end of this thing, it is going to be kicking in all of that colder air and really feeding off of the Great Lakes as well, keeping snow showers and those snow bursts pretty much in play all the way through the night tonight. And you can just see again where all of that snow is covering portions of New York here. And again, we just saw one of those bursts of snow make its way through Johnson City. There it is in that dark blue right there. It's drifting off towards eastern Broome County, and those will be again in play for the rest of the night, along with those very strong winds that we are also going to see. Temperature wise, we have definitely dropped down 10 degrees or so from this afternoon, lower 30s for many of us, and there are some of those wind speeds, sustained wind speeds right now, anywhere from 10 to even 25 miles an hour up at the Binghamton Airport right now. And these will only get in even stronger still as we go throughout the night tonight. Here are some of those wind gusts we've seen, not quite reaching 40 miles an hour yet here in Binghamton, but off to the west, some wind gusts easily lately have been right there in the upper 40s and upwards of 55 miles an hour over in Buffalo. So again, the wind is the main concern tonight, along with that snowfall we could see as well. Now we're catching a break right now, and I say break where the winds are a little bit lighter in some locations, but we're going to see gusts tonight 40 to 50 miles an hour, but the strongest gusts are going to occur right near sunrise tomorrow. We'll see them upwards of 50 to 60 miles an hour, and power outages are certainly still a possibility here tonight, so you want to be prepared just in case you do lose power. But again, those impacts, again, the highest we'll see is right around sunrise tomorrow, but those strong winds will be all the way into the afternoon before we finally start to see a decrease in those wind speeds tomorrow evening and then into Tuesday. Let's check that out here in Future Track with those wind gust speeds here tonight. Again, we could see some spots getting over 50 miles an hour, but the strongest wind gusts occurring right there closer to sunrise tomorrow. Some places reaching close to, again, that 60 mile an hour range, and we'll keep those around as we go throughout the day tomorrow again before we finally start to see those die down on Monday evening. Now, precipitation wise, again, that snowfall is going to be around in bursts all the way into the morning tomorrow. As we head towards the afternoon, though, and drier air finally does move in, the lake effect will slow down a bit, and we'll see those snow showers decrease the farther in the day and into the evening we go here for our Monday. And as far as temperatures are concerned, we're going to continue to get colder all the way through the night tonight, and with temperatures dropping into the teens by sunrise, those blustery winds will feel that much colder as we get into the day tomorrow, as temperatures struggle to recover back into the 20s as more of an Arctic air mass does set up on the backside of this system. For tonight, we'll be around 21 degrees. Again, those winds will continue to pick up, and the strongest wind gusts will be in the early morning, but overnight tonight, 40 to 50 miles an hour there. Thankfully enough, as we head into the week ahead here, calmer weather prevails as temperatures stay in the 20s and 30s.
And as you're going to work tomorrow morning, making sure you're driving very safely, because those winds can be very hard to drive in.
That's right. If you run into one of those snow bursts or snow drifts, that'll also be something you want to watch out for.
Yeah, we absolutely will. Thank you so much, Damon. And after the break, the Bulldogs.